kittens, Jaymes Mansfield here, and you're watching Idol Worship, the show where we honor the friends of Dorothy long after the rainbow has passed. It's kind of like Oprah's masterclass, only gayer and more influential, depending on who's watching. Today, we tackle the original baddest bitch, Bette Davis. Now, tough ladies in history have always been an obsession of mine, and Bette Davis was one different kind of tough. She pulled herself up from her bootstraps and made a star of herself using just talent alone.
Child, you're out of your mind. You know you can't wear red to the Olympus Ball.
Can't I? I'm going to. This is 1852, Dumplin'. 1852, not the Dark Ages. Girls don't have to simp around in white just because they're not married.
Now, in her early career, she was criticized heavily for her looks. She was seen as very unattractive and unappealing, as opposed to her contemporaries like Joan Crawford. She even lost the lead role in Frankenstein, playing Elizabeth. Who'd you think I meant? Her first couple film roles were really forgettable. It wasn't until she got a breakout role in the film The Man Who Played God that things really started to spark up for her. But it wasn't until she lobbied and campaigned for the role of Mildred in Of Human Bondage that she really broke out as a star and found her niche.
You bored me stiff. I hated you. It made me sick when I had to let you kiss me. I only did it because you begged me. You hounded me. You drove me crazy. And after you kissed me, I always used to wipe my mouth. Wipe my mouth!
Bette Davis learned that playing a nice girl will take you far, but playing a bad girl will take it even further. Of Human Bondage was based off of Somerset Maugham's novel and was later adapted into a film starring her and Leslie Howard. It's a brilliant film where Bette spends a good chunk of 90 minutes emasculating Leslie Howard and then dying from tuberculosis. Her acting in her youth can be summed up with a lot of shouting or playing rich bitches who do terrible things and often get away with it.
Now, if I hurt you.
Hurt me? You delight me. You have the most amazing lack of humor of anyone I've ever known. Oh, I should laugh at you, should I, but I can't help it. You were so awkward that I almost laughed in your face at first, and then it made me quite sick to think that anyone could be stupid enough to be taken in by a lot of old tricks. I thought you might at least be amusing, but you turned out to be dull and stupid and so afraid. Well, you needn't be. I won't hurt your Sunday school romance or your oh-so-nice career. Hurt me? Get out of here before you give me hysterics!
By the time the 40s had rolled around, though, it was time for Bette to reinvent herself. So she made a star of herself in women's pictures, like Dark Victory, Mr. Skeffington, and her magnum opus, Now Voyager.
My darling, you are crying. Oh, I'm such a fool.
Such an old fool. These are only tears of gratitude. An old maid's gratitude for the crumbs off it.
Her career started to decline, and her film Beyond the Forest was murdered by critics.
Rosa, you're a scream.
I want you to marry me.
However, as time progressed, gays rediscovered the film and is now a treasured gem of camp among gay film circles.
What a dump.
But needless to say, after sour reviews, Bette's career was seemingly over with.
Come on, Oscar. Let you and me get drunk.
And by 1959, she had left Warner Brothers and seemingly was put off to better pastures.
I finished 18 years at Warner's, built many sound stages there, never got a letter of goodbye, ended up in the back lot with a sound man, Heinz Blanke, a producer, till dawn, having drinks, and that's how I left the Warner lot.
But the year was 1950, and Claudette Colbert had hurt her back doing a stunt on a film she was just wrapping up. Claudette Colbert was cast a star in the film All About Eve. With Claudette Colbert out of the picture, there was only one actress around with the pedigree to pull off such a role, and that lady was Bette Davis, who would solidify herself in the role of her career as Margot Channing in All About Eve.
You're in a beehive, pal, didn't you know? We're all busy little bees, full of stings, making honey day and night. Aren't we, honey?
All About Eve was a film about an aging actress and a younger upstart who has her eyes on her career and her man.
Newbie host, it's your party. Happy birthday, welcome home. And we who are about to die salute you.
Need any help?
put me to bed, take my clothes off, hold my head, tuck me in, turn out the lights, and tiptoe out. Eve would, wouldn't you, Eve?
If you'd like.
I wouldn't like.
Now a soaring star again, Bette Davis had her choice of film roles. Bette Davis never worried about being beautiful. She wanted to look like the character she was portraying on the screen. She'd shave back her hairline to look like the Virgin Queen.
You dare turn your back on Elizabeth of England? You dare?
But sadly, things don't last forever, and like before, Bette Davis's career started to wane yet again in the late 1950s.
You're not my friend.
Really?
You're not anybody's friend. They kicked you out. They found out about you. You don't belong here. You're not the librarian anymore. You're a communist. The communist. The communist. The communist.
Stop it. 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 Stop it.
Reaching her 50s, roles really had seemed to dry up for her. Hungry for work, she put a Help Wanted ad out to help find film roles for her. This stunt, however, caught the attention of director Robert Aldrich, who was in the process of casting a film based off a book by Henry Farrell. The only catch was, her co-star was her long-hated rival, Joan Crawford. The two rivals were paired up to make the film Whatever Happened to Baby Jane, a film about two aging sisters in Hollywood who are sitting on a very, very dark secret.
You wouldn't be able to do these awful things to me if I weren't still in this chair.
But you are, Blanche. You are in that chair.
The film was a bizarre, macabre look into the mind and psyche of a woman who's deteriorating over time.
Now, when I'm very good and do as I am told, I'm Mama's little angel and Papa says I'm good as gold. But when I'm very bad and answer back and sass, then I'm Mama's little devil, and Papa says I've got the brass. Now I wish that you would tell me, 'cause I'm much too young to know.
And the pairing of the two proved to be a monstrous success, and the film was a sleeper hit no one saw coming, and reignited the careers of both Bette and Joan Crawford, who went on to round up the 60s with dozens of film roles ranging from more horror films to some more bizarre. Bette Davis was up and at it again, and established as a well-respected star. It was this role that forever cemented her as a gay icon, and is by far her most quoted. It's even served as inspiration for the Ryan Murphy series, Feud. As queens, we relate a lot to bitchy characters, and Bette Davis played a lot of those in her career. She was strong, she never took crap from anyone, and she made it off talent alone. Bette Davis represented a strength we could see inside of ourselves, even at a time when we weren't allowed to show it.
If I find out that you or anybody else has laid a finger on her...
You'll what?
I'll get you. Even if I have to crawl back from my grave to do it.
You were a great dame, Miss Davis, stealing scenes, smoking cigs, and throwing shade right up to the very end. I thank you, Miss Davis, and we queens salute you. Now, slow curtain, the end.